That costs extra, Jim. Really? That costs extra.
One, two.
Yeah, nice. All right.
I just colored my hair, so.
How you doing, everybody? So, today we're not unplugged. Today we're plugged.
Plugged.
What? We're plugged. We're plugged. We're going to do the same thing we do during the show. Sweet. We're going to fake playing and lip sync.
Nice. First kiss show right here. Woo!
Give it to her.
That's
all
you. Yeah, Zozo.
Nice.
We gotta go.
Come on, Paul.
My collar is up for you. My collar is up for you, big G.
All right. Well, what do you want to hear? I'll tell you what I want to hear, my voice. One, two, one, two. One, two, one, two. One, two, one, two. There I go. We got Gene out of the bath. We got Gene out of the bath to come do sound check. Let's do
Mr. Speed.
We're doing Rock
and Roll Hell.
I still love you. I can't even remember.
I swear to you, we're much better than that.
Don't ask for something that you're going to regret.
And it's going to get worse.
How about Plaster Caster?
Getting late.
Yeah, real rumbly. Very distinct. Now you know we're not really playing. We're not really singing. But if you hang around long enough, in a couple hours, Kiss is coming out. How about Hotter Than Hell?
Yeah!
Can you sing it?
Yeah!
So can I. Ready? One, two, three!
What are you saying? I cut a nice figure in this outfit.
No, I was just... You're a champ.
I was.
In this corner, weigh 242 pounds. In this corner, 242, Uncle Shravis.
I gotcha, that's right. Raindrops,
so many
raindrops,
so many raindrops
falling from my eyes, falling from my eyes, and the end is
there must be a
keeps on falling. Before you were born, you have no idea what you're doing. Are you two a couple? Would you like to be? Where's Emily Field? Where's Emily Field? Where's she?
How about Got to Choose? Ready? help me. Thank you very much. Why don't we take a couple of questions?
Will you marry
now him? Is the time to ask. Oh, wait. Who's got a microphone? Right over here.
All right, Gene, Paul, Tommy. Hi.
Hi.
Eric.
Where are you? Right over there.
You know, Eric is single.
I'm not single, sorry. Are the boots really 7 inches?
I could lie to you.
Most men do.
How? Is this 7 inches?
In your dreams, maybe.
No, in your dreams.
Yeah, that's. No, they are. And Eric would like to prove it.
And it has a battery in it.
Hey guys, listen. You don't know me and my brother, but we grew up with you guys. I took you to Afghanistan and Iraq when I deployed, and I want to say thank you. I got this military challenge coin. My question is, I want to trade this for a pick.
Can I give you more than that?
Yes.
I mean, I'm straight, but...
A kiss.
Of course.
Thank you.
Can you arrange for him to come backstage and lubricate and all that? Yeah. We kid around a lot, but for you to serve, everybody talks the talk, you walk the walk.
God bless you.
My pleasure, Gene. My pleasure. Thank you.
God bless you. A real hero. Thank you. We can't hear you.
I first off wanted to thank Gene for about 15 years ago showing my father here how to properly wear this coat with the collar turned up. So with that, thank you very much, Gene. My question is for Paul. Charlie Miller, who was a taper for the Grateful Dead, posted on an internet forum in 2010 that he recorded you guys in Oakland, California. And during the show, you guys started making jokes that you enjoyed the Grateful Dead and their music, and you actually guys started playing Uncle John's band. Is there any validity to that, or is Charlie Miller confused?
Actually, we're a lot like the Grateful Dead because we don't know Uncle John's band any better than they do.
Does that mean you played it?
I don't think so. Well, the first days are the hardest days. Don't you worry anymore.
Cause when life wants life.
If I can answer door, anybody's choice. I can hear your voice. Oh, Lord, and I want to know, where does the time go? You know, Gene taught you how to wear your collar. Today he's showing you how to wear a bathrobe.
Just in time. Paul.
Yes.
I deployed too to Desert Shield, Desert Storm with the Marine Corps. And I would love to get a guitar pick from your hand.
Semper Fi, sir.
Thank you, Gene. Thank you, Paul. Paul, I want to thank you. During the COVID years, you recorded those little instructional. They were fucking amazing. And they got me motivated and relaxed. And it was like sitting down with you playing guitar. And I just want to say thank you. And I do have a question. Gene, you are the fucking best. Eric Singer, you are the worst, best drummer in the universe. Tommy Thayer, we love you. And my question, I'm sorry.
Nope.
My question is, do you have an alpha guitar that you go to at home that inspires you more than any other of your instruments?
You know, we were just talking yesterday. Sometimes old guitars just have a magic. They have a life even before you had them. So you know, you pick up something like a 1959 Sunburst Les Paul and you just think, you know, Jimmy Page, Eric Clapton, you think of all these greats and here you are holding a guitar that's in that bloodline. So there are certain guitars, sure, that you pick up, but as far as those videos during COVID, you know, I think it was important for everybody to realize that we were all in that together, you know, and nobody was going through anything that anybody wasn't. Some people were devastated, you know, as far as health or finances. So, you know, it made me feel good to reach out to you. I didn't just do it for you, I needed it. So thank you so much, and thank you for serving. Wow, a song from the 80s. Probably Burn Bitch Burn.
Got nasty habits. I was thinking of No No No. That's just, that's not, I don't know why we don't, I don't know why we don't do that. I don't know. Actually, if you're looking for poetry, I'll give you a little poetry. Burn Bitch Burn has a middle section goes, I've got nasty habits, it's a fine line, so many girls and so little time. When love rears its head, I want to get on your case. I want to put my log in your fireplace.
That's poetry. That's classic shit.
Uncle Jim, that's not good.
You know what's even better? You're saying those lines in a bathroom. A song from the 80s. Some of those songs, I mean, honestly, I was singing in keys that only dogs could hear. You know, I mean, songs like Hell to Hold You or things like that. I couldn't sing those now with a gun to my head. I mean, you know, that's a while ago. That's a while ago. But there's a lot of great songs.
Rise to it.
So thank you. One more.
Hi.
Tried to say I'm sorry. Didn't mean to break your heart.
Hi. So, first of all, I want to thank you guys because you guys, your music helped me get through my really hard battle with depression that I've had. So I want to thank you for that, first of all. But my question is, what is your favorite song that you've ever written?
Before, what you started with is really important. Anybody who has any kind of mental issues, any kind of depression, anything you're struggling with, reach out. Reach out and find people who can support you. There's loads of groups, there's a suicide hotline. Nobody's in this alone. And sometimes we feel like we're in it alone. And we need something to hold on to. So glad you found something. And everybody else, please, if you're troubled, if something's going on that's bothering you or making you feel isolated, reach out. You know, it will pass. That's what, when you give up hope, that's when you're in trouble. You know, if you don't have faith, find people who have faith in you. Okay, question was a favorite song?
My question was, what was your favorite song you've ever written?
Tommy's there. Tommy's a writer. Stairway to Heaven?
No. I don't know. You should ask these guys. They wrote more of the songs.
Gene?
Well, Eric got writing credit on Back to the Stone Age.
It's not your favorite song. Do You Love Me? Do You Love Me is your favorite song?
I like Strange Ways.
Yeah!
I like to say songs that we wrote, that I wrote. I really, really like Got to Choose. And Detroit Rock City and Love Gun. Thank you.
Gene, tonight's Russell's 397th show.
We have a guy who's from New York. I call him Rocky. Some of those call him Rocky. He has been all over the world and has seen how many?
397.
397 of our concerts. He was just taken away to Bellevue Hospital. And by the way, day before yesterday, we were in Dayton, I think. He was in the audience. No matter where you go, there he is. Favorite song? You know, songs aren't just songs, they're memories and stuff like that. For me, it's Deuce, not because it's a special song or anything, but we started off the tours early on with that tune, and we ran out of songs to play when we got encores. So we started doing Deuce again on the encore. So for me, it's that one.
What's the first song you guys ever played or wrote, Jacob Paul? First song you
ever wrote?
First Kiss song.
Oh, Kiss song.
There was a bash. It was a 100,000-year strutter, Black Diamond.
Let me know.
Deuce.
Watching you.
They all just came. You know, we were excited, and you know, those creative juices were flowing, and it's amazing how many songs. It's like we would meet up at the loft, 10 East 23rd Street, and just sit down and pick up the guitars and strutter, Deuce. You know, it just went on and on and on.
We had to go back at the studio to do a new record, and we were doing two records a year in those days, and tour. And we're recording, we got eight songs, and two more. And all of a sudden, chords came in, and then Ladies in Waiting just kind of happened. Well, thank you for giving me the time.
clothes.
You gotta put makeup on.
Yeah. You get it? Because I was going to tell you, it's like Christmas.